Hey guys, it's IntuitiveMara here. Just thought I would give my fellow beauty guru ladies or gents out there a little sneak peek of my new beauty station, beauty hair station, my vanity set that I had worked on this past weekend. I went ahead and I did a sanding and a staining varnish that had the gloss included on this furniture, so now it looks pretty fancy schmancy. And when everything was said and done, with the chair included and this antique mirror set that's actually electrical, believe it or not, with the lighting on it, the old school lighting, I got everything done with the staining products and the tools to do that. Everything was literally under $200. So I wanted to show this to some of my friends, clients, people who follow me, that you can turn anything that might seem like trash to one person a treasure to another, and it doesn't have to cost you an arm and a leg. Vanities nowadays run from $500 and up for a vanity, or your other option would be either the antique stores, or if you go to like IKEA, you can customize the table and leg sets, which are actually great for the price. But me personally, me being IntuitiveMara, I prefer to actually have something unique, different, something with character, something more between the 1920s, 1940s-esque. You know, I didn't want any run-of-the-mill, modern, what everyone else has. I just don't. Now, I might end up later on doing a more modern mirror, which is fine, but for the time being, I got something with more character anyway. So, the only items I did not stain that are included in this video is the mirror and the chair, which I actually forgot to stain. But honestly, right now anyway, it's not really necessary. I can if I want. I have leftover product for it. But my main concern was just getting everything together nicely, and the desk was like the biggest thing for me. That was like more big deal for me. So this is one of the popular antique desks that sell very quickly. It doesn't matter if it's at a consignment or at an actual store. This seems to be one of the popular type of designs, if you will, and they have them as dressers as well. So this has the original antique dresser drawer pullouts. So it's really cool. I'll try to give you guys a little bit of a rundown here. I have this in my bedroom, actually. I'm going to try and see if I can show you a little sneak preview of the work that I had done over the weekend. Sanding and staining. I'll try to make it as straight as possible. So there is my vanity that was originally a desk, I believe, but more, old school. And the table, the chair for the table. It's just a simple chair, and it has what looks like a gold design, like a beige gold design, floral design on here. It's actually the material. It's not your typical fabric, surprisingly. It's something more like heavy duty. So if you get messes or spills on it, you can just wipe it off real easy. I just noticed that actually. So this is my set here, and I'll try to give you guys a better close-up view. Okay. Don't mind me. I'm new with experimenting with the camera for the vanity station. I'll try to keep it as straight for you as possible. Okay. So this is not lit up right now because I need to get bulbs for it. But surprisingly, it's electrical. So for being an antique piece, I was actually pleasantly surprised. And I got an amazing deal on it for being an antique. Now I'll try to straighten this for you. On my desk here, a lot of these items are things you can buy at the store, or you can find online, or at some of the consignment antique-y shops, like these glass perfume sets. You can put your own perfume in there if you want to use a little at a time, or you can use it strictly for decor. What I actually did, the extra step I went ahead and did from collecting these pieces little by little, is I actually put some jewelry on them to accent and further design the items. I'll try to give you guys a little bit of a close-up. Hopefully it'll give you a clear view. So you can actually do that. You can do that. If you have any leftover jewelry that maybe you just don't use, or it came out of an auction or something, you can actually use this to accent, to add more character to the items on your vanity. This clock actually is one of those antique clocks from back in the day. It actually still works. Surprisingly, it works. And I like that it gives character. And I have a clock on my station. And I really liked it. Honestly, I really liked it. So I kept it here. And then I have some antique odds and ends from back of the day that would hold, you know, different perfume sets. You know, some of this is like really, really old school. Like Avon, you know, bottles back in the day. Things like that. Very antique-y collectible items. Really cool. And these, usually they don't cost too terribly much. It just depends where you go. So you might want to do some research as far as what antique items that are glass that you want on your vanity. For anyone who's trying to get a vanity together, I would recommend take your time doing your research looking for items like this that you may want. So it depends what kind of style you're looking for. So just take your time with it. I collected things little by little by little. I had to get one of my two makeup boxes here to try and, you know, add my collection little by little before I even got this whole furniture set. It took a while. It took me months researching everywhere, from Craigslist, just everywhere. And I'm very finicky, a little picky with what I like. And I'm not going to pay $700-$800 unless I have a nice big old house. Then, you know, and I can blow some money, then I don't care. But, you know, something that's within my budget that still gives the character I want, that's totally, you know, my thing. And I'm all about storage space. Anyone who knows me knows I love things that are practical at the end of the day while still being very nice. If you don't mind doing the do-it-yourself projects like this table that I did, how it's nice and glazed and everything, it brought the wood new life. So it's still more or less the same color, but it looks richer. I like things that look richer in color and more classic. So it definitely brought it to life. So it was definitely worth a weekend of sanding and staining. I put a couple layers of this on here. Just to give you an idea, these cases, anyone who's looking for cases like this, these cases retail anywhere, depending where you're looking, anywhere between $10 and $40. Just telling you right now. These are actually two, I'll show you. They're just piled on top of each other. These are really great for holding whatever you need to hold, makeup, whatever. I specifically like these that have this type of handle. There are some out there that have more of a plastic thin line handle. I do not like those. That's kind of a personal preference at that point, what you like. I like these because they're a little bit more durable. They're easy, less hassle to pull in, pull out, versus those little plasticky ones that you might actually see some on eBay. I got these specifically from Amazon. I was close to buying on eBay. I'm an eBay queen. I always look for a good deal. I never pay full price on anything. I always find a sale price or somewhere cheaper. I never, ever, ever pay full price unless it's one of those items, you know, that lasts for years and years and years, that's over $100, that's different. But something like this that's practical, useful, I'm not going to pay no $40 per thing. Why should I? I bought these. One was $10, one was $15 on Amazon right after Christmas. They had like a daily deal. They do like a daily deal on Amazon.
I know eBay does it too, where you can get for that day only, you can get a deal on the first item and then the second item is regular price or less than. So I got one at like $10, one at 15. So when everything was said and done, I got it for what, $25? So basically the price of one, I got two. So you always want to do your research. That's why I always tell my friends and my clients alike, do your research. Whatever it is you want, put the intention out there. You put the intention out there, what you want, and you will attract it. Besides being an intuitive, psychic, what have you, I always put the intention out there of what I want, and so I know I'm gonna get it. So it's really just a matter of timing as far as getting the items. I've been having this intent on my vanity, everything, for, at least 5 months, I would like to say, maybe a little more. And look, I got it sooner than I thought I would when everything was said and done. So it's all about manifesting the intentions. I try to, feed that knowledge to my clients alike. If I can do it, so can you. But you gotta have faith and be persistent on it, okay? Just as example. Now, some other great things I found, which you can find pretty much anywhere, any store, auctions, Pier 1, whatever. You can find some of these antique-y type glass items, which I actually use for hair stuff. So, like for me, I use my bobby pins, which I'll have to buy more. Bobby pins are something like women always have to buy more of, they lose them. And hair clips from when you're styling your hair. So, this vanity is not only for makeup, it's also for hair too. I was able to fit everything for to accommodate both. So, that's great. So, now my bathroom has more space and it's cleaner. And then I got just one of these vases, if you will, a glass one for my makeup brushes. And I put a little bit of those beads or whatever. In this case, they're like rocks. You can actually get this at the dollar store. That's where I got mine at. There's different ways you can store your brushes depending on what your preference is. I prefer for my everyday ones in there. Now, I know it's better ideally to have them covered, kept covered, to avoid dust and that, but honestly, you gotta clean your brushes every week anyway. So honestly, there's not much of a difference to me. I do have extra brushes actually that I store differently for if I have friends over to do makeovers for. I have my leftover in here because I got a 36 piece. So there's still more brushes in there. I just don't use them every day. Another tip, ladies and gents, if you're a chocoholic like me and you ever get any of these plastic or crystal like boxes as gifts, like Ferrero Rocher chocolates example, keep them. You can double up storage on these cases. So they actually end up being cheap for you because they're a gift. You can double it up. I put this for my blushes. I have other blushes elsewhere, but they're not the good ones. So I separate what's like play makeup for kids, if I have any kids over or whatever. Any friends' kids. So I'm kind of like the aunt in a way. So, keep your Ferrero Rocher boxes. You can double up on using them for more additional storage. So there's my extra brushes accumulated over the years. So if I have someone that needs to use them or borrow them when they come over before going out, getting ready to go out, I let them use those and I have mine for me. So, pretty cool, pretty cool, very accommodating. And I still have a lot of space. I have these semi-plastic bags that are good to store anything else additional. I keep them just in case. I don't need them right now, but they're there. So I wanted to give you guys a little sneak peek to Intuitive Mara's vanity that I literally just did this weekend and put everything together. Like this just got here like not even 2 days ago. So I had to lug it up here. At least I had an elevator, so it was fine. So yeah, another thing too, if you can find these glass cases, like the very antique-y ones, or at an estate sale, you can find these at estate sales really cheap as well if you have any estate sales in your area. I use mine for specifically, like you can use it for cotton balls or the face cottons. That's what I use for mine. Specifically, For makeup removal, or for if you made a mistake, whatever. So I find that it's definitely helpful, not expensive. If you know where to shop, and be budget friendly and thrifty, and you're a creative person, this should be easy for you. If you're someone who maybe might not be as creative, that's okay. Ask one of your friends or girlfriends that can help, help you shopping wise and everything. Now these paintings I have in the back, they are real paintings. I actually have two. I don't know if you can tell or not. I can move this. It's a lady, a fashionista lady, with her pet cheetah over here. I actually have a set of two. Now, this and the mirror, both of them and the mirror, will be hung up at some point. But remember, this just came in. I just brought everything and put it all together. And so right now I'm not in a rush to do it. That's not a priority at the moment, but it will be. But I like how it is right now, honestly. So who knows? I might just leave it. Now, for the makeup people, I'll do this real quickly. If you're someone who would like to know what kind of makeups I have for right now at the time being, which I still accumulate more, this is for everybody else who likes to watch. What do you have in your vanity? If not, you can end the video here. That's fine. So, I've been using lately BH Cosmetics Rose Color, the Blush Duo. This is a blush, okay? These go for about $5. You can get them cheaper or even free, depending what's going on the site. They give you like a two color there, rouge, if you will. I got this one free because I spent $20 or more with the company during one of the specials, and the special was if you bought $20 or more worth of product, you got that free, like a free gift. So you just gotta keep tabs on BH Cosmetics. They always do new sales literally every 2 weeks. They always have sales going on. You gotta check them like constantly. They're a great budget-friendly, makeup brand that you can order items literally online. So I've definitely took a liking to them because they're fairly budget-friendly, good products for the price. Honestly, you're not going to find many products out there, many companies that are budget-friendly that are still good quality. It's always like a hit or miss for some of us makeup folks, if you will. So they're definitely one of my favorite companies. So sometimes I hold out longer just to have a better sale, because sometimes they do up the price by a couple of dollars, but then they drop it down when they have specials. So I'm always, keeping tabs on them. So I do like BH Cosmetics. So if you do see some BH Cosmetics, that's why. As far as foundation and concealers, I definitely have been all about the CoverGirl, absolutely. That's like my thing, is CoverGirl. I used to actually use, back in the day, the more pricey brands, Clinique. I used to be all about Clinique. However, I've noticed in the summertime, putting on the liquid foundation with the concealer and everything, it would cover great, but in the summer, it would melt off, and I'd have to redo my entire face while we're out and about. And with the cost in relation to having a higher upkeep in the summer, because it just wouldn't stick it out all day if it's humid, I ended up actually downgrading to CoverGirl Maybelline on some of the items. And honestly, I've never looked back, because I have oily skin. I do. I have more of an oily skin type. So even though I do love Clinique to a point, honestly, the concealer coverage and durability all day wear, I gotta go with CoverGirl. I just can't not go with them, unless I find something else over time I try that I'll like. So in the meantime, that's what I use. I haven't looked back since. Now as far as Clinique, what I do like more, even though I don't really order from them right now, is their mascaras are really good. their lipsticks are really good. I haven't cared to look at their lipsticks in a while, only because I'm someone who has to have matte lips, something that's durable, that lasts for hours. And even though they have great lipsticks, in passing, I haven't seen anything that was matte worthy, and I'm all about the matte. So, you know, I have different, you know, brands that are specifically matte lipsticks, whether it's liquid or an actual, you know, waxier, like, lipstick, an actual stick. So, what I'm trying to accumulate right now is more of the highlighters. This one I haven't tried yet. It's actually by e.l.f. I've heard good things about e.l.f. So I thought, and it was on sale, I thought, well, I'll get one, I'll try one. You know, I've heard good things. I've gotten a couple things, and LA Colors in there. And right now, a highlighter I'm using, that's actually a powder, I really like. It's in the bathroom, I forgot to bring it. But it's an illuminator, and it's from Bare Minerals. And I believe it's called, like, Superstar or something like that. It might be discontinued, even though they have other ones. But it's my favorite. You can find that stuff on eBay. If something is discontinued that you like, look on Amazon and eBay, sites like that. Sometimes they'll still have discontinued items there for a little bit. Okay, so just, you know, do that. If you really have your heart set on something that's, like, discontinued, that's what I would recommend until they run out. So that's what I do too. Lip pencils, the lip liners. I need to stock up on lip liners because I don't have many. I haven't really been big on them. I'm sure I will. I'm starting to a little bit now, only because I do like doing the ombre lip. So the ombre lip, you can do two colors, three colors. This one that's really good is Maybelline Wear & Go Long Wearing Lip Liner. And then I have some cheaper brands, Mark Wins, that came in one of the makeup gift sets that you can get during the holidays at, like, Walmart. They give you a little bit of everything. So I'm trying to stock up on those. Wish, the Wish.com or Wish app is good too for some items. Just do your research in advance, so you know you're getting the actual product, not a copycat. Unless you don't care if it's a copycat. That's kind of up to you. Okay, this section here is strictly for chapped lips, the chapstick, and a couple of the really, really good lipsticks, but they're not matte. They're just your regular run-of-the-mill lipsticks. So I do have Clinique. This color is Raspberry Glaze. I don't know if the camera will show you, but it's Raspberry Glaze. That's actually really pretty. I wanted to keep it because it's really nice, even though it's not matte. This one is Color Design Vintage Rose Sheen. It's another old school one. I'm not sure if they're discontinued or not. I'd have to look. I haven't had a chance to look. And then chapsticks, any run-of-the-mill cheap brand chapsticks. I love anything that's vanilla, coconut, or the fruity ones. I do have Burt Bees. I had a peach one. Burt Bees, they can be a little on the pricey side, but you gotta remember they're natural or organic. So they are healthier for you too, for your lips. But let me tell you, I love these. Now, I buy them once in a blue moon, but I love these. So I actually have a couple. A peach one, which I gotta replace, running low on. And then this one is more of a caramel. These are great. I know they can be a little pricey, but they're actually really great. If you're someone who would wear it every day, then it's worth it. You might be able to find a cheap or two online. I honestly haven't looked in a while. EOS. I do have a couple EOS. One is like watermelon, one is like a strawberry, kiwi. I've heard mixed things about this, that certain people get breakouts or some kind of reaction to it. I'm going to assume the people who've had issues with these have special skin requirements, that they shouldn't be using just any old thing, because I haven't had any problems with it. So if you do have problems with it, you know, be very careful when getting any product, you know, to sample it first, because if you're very sensitive, that can happen. Yes, I haven't had issues with EOS, but I've heard some mixed things about it, so I just thought I'd throw that out there. Okay. And also another tip too for my clients and friends alike and makeup enthusiasts, if you see a brand or a product from a brand that you really, really like, but you don't want to pay the full price, let's say it's $20, $30 for something and you don't even know if you like it, you want to try it first, go on Amazon, go on eBay, go online, see where you can find a sale price of the original item so you can try it cheaper to find out if you even like it at all. Then if you like it, you can always order in bulk the original items from the original company on their website. Sometimes the original companies do have great sales on their websites. It's kind of touch and go. So just a thought, food for thought. Sometimes they have good deals, sometimes not so much. So you just gotta, you know, keep up, check in here and there. The next section here that I have is matte lipsticks, specifically matte lipsticks. Now I'm gonna start with the one in the back because it is, I consider it a matte, even though technically it's not. It's one of those that's a lipstick that almost feels a little like a, what's the word? Kind of like a chapstick, but it's really a lipstick. But it has nice color. It's not drying at all. And it does last for a little bit, even though you do have to reapply it. It's Perpetual Peach from L'Oreal Infallible, the actual lipstick. It looks like this. This I actually surprisingly liked. I just got this as something to hold me over a while back. And let me tell you, I actually really liked it. Surprisingly, I really liked it. So I might actually stock up on these. I was pretty impressed with them. I got it on sale. I thought, I'll try it. Just pull me over. And I actually ended up liking it. And it lasted a really long time. So, something to think about. So, my matte lipsticks right now for lipsticks. I have BH Cosmetics, the actual lipstick, it looks like this. It's the Color Lock collection. You may have seen this in previous videos. I have various colors. Rapture, there's so many other colors. Rapture, Faithful, what other colors do I have? Dark Rose, Blissful, that's a new one I got that has more of a purple undertone. Devotion. I tend to get colors that are more earth tone colors, like the nudes, the browns, a little bit of the reds. Getting into the purples now. So I have maybe half of the collection, possibly about half, I want to say, or close to a half on the different colors. This one's in a box still because it's brand new and I want to finish the other one first. So when they come in the mail, they come in a box like this, in case you're wondering. BH Cosmetics, these are about maybe $5. You can even get them cheaper if they have a sale. So I do have quite a bit of BH right now. Bottom layer, that is the matte liquid lipsticks. So they're still matte, but it's the liquid lips. Now, I have a whole combination of things here. I'm a lip person. I love lip stuff. I've come to learn. I'm a big lip freak. So, I started originally with BH Cosmetics, as far as the lip stuff's concerned in general. Then I ended up going to ColourPop. ColourPop, I got about four or five different colors. ColourPop, it looks like this. Okay, and I have different colors. I have everything from Avenue, Tool, Stingray, Midi, which I have to comment on Midi. Midi is nice. I don't use it enough. Part of the reason why I don't use it enough is because it matches so well to my skin tone. Excuse me. It matches so well to my skin tone. It matches too well that my lips, I feel like they disappear. It matches a little too good, and I like the lip products that are like the nudes, but a little bit darker, so you can still get that depth, you know, like, when you're wearing it. This one, I feel like totally nude, a little too nude, so I'll probably use this more when I get, like, a gloss that's glittery or something to offset it, So I've been holding on to this. I've only worn it a couple times, strictly because it matches too well for me. So it's great. It is great. But if you want it to stick out a little bit, get a shade or two darker from your skin color. I've noticed that that's better, and I prefer it that way. So ColourPop. ColourPop is about $6 each. Shipping is $5. Unless you're a new customer, you get $5 off the first couple times, the first couple orders. This is one, if not the cheapest liquid matte lipstick, the liquid one, out there that you will find on the market. Just telling you right now. So if you're someone who's on a tight budget that wants a pretty good quality product that's very pigmented and that lasts hours, for the majority, you want to get ColourPop. I do recommend ColourPop. Even if I try higher-end brands, ColourPop is still a good go-to, especially when you're in between shopping for stuff and you're a little bit limited at the moment, or for an interview for the ladies. Definitely something to have. Definitely something to have. You can't beat the price. My mom tried it a while back. She got hooked on it. I got her hooked. So I actually have an order that was supposed to be coming today. It might be in there later today. We ordered some more. So definitely ColourPop all the way. This liquid lipstick I'm wearing today that is a matte, this is actually ColourPop as well. So I am wearing ColourPop today, actually. I always switch between the different brands. Let me see if I have it in my back pocket. I think I do. Just to show you, if you're wondering what color I'm wearing today. Today, I am wearing Stingray. Stingray is the color. Hopefully, the camera will show you. If not, just to let you know, the color is Stingray. Okay? Very pretty color. A lot of great colors. I got Stingray Tool. A lot of great colors for, you know, mixing it up and for every day. So definitely something to have for sure. And it doesn't cost, you know, as much as some of the other brands out there. Okay? I find with ColourPop, I'll say it in this video, I've said it in a previous video mention, it's great. It does last for hours. I was actually out all morning and this hasn't budged. Just know that when you go out eating, you might have to touch it up a little bit. When you eat, it does come off a little bit, the inner part of the lip. But other than that, really good for the price. So, just a thought. Another brand I started to try, I only bought one for now to make sure that I like it first before I order more from the company. I found this company online, literally on the fly, just from researching. If you're someone like me who researches online as you work or on your breaks, whatever, you tend to find companies online that maybe you never heard of. This was one of them. This was Gerard Cosmetics Color Your Smile Lip Gloss. This one is actually a lip gloss. It's not considered a matte lipstick. It's considered a lip gloss. But let me tell you, and I'm not a big lip gloss person. I used to be, not anymore, I'll be honest. For not being a lip gloss person anymore at all, because I love my mattes, let me tell you, this is gorgeous. Very great color. I do have this on another video. The color I got was Pretty Penny. It's like an orange coppery color. And it has little tiny bits of like a shimmer in it. For lip gloss, it's very pigmented. It does last for a while. And also, original retail value of this item would be $20. It was on sale in the clearance section on their personal website for literally $9.40, free shipping. They had free shipping. They probably still have free shipping. Definitely you want to try this. I'm all about when I want to try high-end products, because I'm starting to slowly get back into high-end products that I haven't tried before lip-wise. I always want to try it at a sale price to know I like it before investing more serious money on the products. Always check the clearance. You never know what you're going to find. This was a great find. When you open this, I'll open this real quickly for you. Let me put my video up here. Sorry if it's shaky. But basically, okay, just to show you, I gotta show you this. This particular company, not all companies have this, but it might be packaged similarly. Okay, this one lights up. Now, I don't know if the light will turn on right now. I haven't used it in a while. But this actually does have a light. I think the light actually went out. I've had it for a bit though. But it's really, really, really cool. Isn't that really pretty? It does actually have a light. When you unscrew it, there's a light in there. It's just not on right now. I think it's because I had it a while. But I'm sure there's a way to replace the battery. I'll have to figure that out. Because I thought it was really cool when you're out on the go. And it has a mirror. And there is the color. And it does look like that. Okay. Very pigmented. Very nice. Okay. Definitely recommend. I had to say a little piece on it because I really like it. I do plan on buying more from this company. I just haven't yet. I know they have a discount code. If you search them on Facebook or whatever. I think it's like GC30, I want to say is the code. They haven't really changed the code. I think it's the same code. I do have some old school stuff in here that's discontinued or maybe discontinued. That's good. Bare Minerals Marvelous Moxie Lip Gloss. Like I said, I'm not a big lip gloss person, but these are good for, you know, errands, on the go, something just for now kind of thing. You know, everyday wear. I actually really like this. Even though it's not something that lasts for hours, it does last for a bit. For a lip gloss, and it is gorgeous, and it's from Bare Minerals. I was given this because the person who bought the collection of Bare Minerals didn't care for this in particular. They gave it to me, and surprisingly, I love it. So there are some stuff from Bare Minerals I love. The foundation makeup stuff, it just doesn't work for my skin, for coverage-wise, but their eyeshadows, their lip stuff, their illuminators, their highlighters that I mentioned earlier are definitely good. You can find those on eBay too if you don't want to pay the full retail price. This one's a love-hate. I should probably chuck it, but I wanted to replace it. Superstay 24-Hour Color by Maybelline. This is a love-hate for me. Color is gorgeous. The only reason why I don't care for it as much as you would think is because it says it's 24-hour. It is not 24-hour. You're lucky if it's even 2 hours. So that's why it's not on my top list. It is nice, but I would not even consider this in the matte family at all because it really doesn't last that long at all. I'm lucky if it lasts 2 hours. So 24 hours, misconception. Color-wise, though, nice color. It is a gorgeous color. And then anyone who knows, you know, this line of products, they have the clear moisture side that's more of a lip chap with a little gloss, and it's to keep your lips, to seal it and to keep it moisturized. These are great, but I've noticed if you buy anything that has a two-stepper, you always gotta buy an extra one of these clear moisturizer chapstick balms because you always run out of this right before this. That's how it always is. So this is a couch 22, so it's on my list of love hates. I like it, I like the idea, but it's like I gotta be in the mood to want to use this. I'm sorry, that's just my personal opinion. But otherwise, nice color, idea is great. A little misleading though on the 24-hour, I'll be honest. So no, it's not kiss proof. Something that's more kiss proof is like ColourPop. These are some cheap mattes, liquid mattes I found on eBay. I wanted to try it, honestly, just for the hell of it. And because I've seen them around online, shopping-wise, they're so cheap. They're only $1. I thought, what the hell, let me try it. Just as something to hold you over kind of thing. They're $1. They have different names or different brands, but it's really the same product, honestly. Danimer Long Lasting Lip Gloss. Now, here they consider it a lip gloss. Or a matte lip gloss. If they're only $1, you can find them at like eBay,
Wish.com app or pretty much anywhere online. So you'll probably think it's common because you may have seen, if you shopped around online like I have, you'll see it has like the same design, everything. Now these are very pigmented. For a dollar, let me tell you, I'm surprised how pigmented they are. Now you may have to put two or three layers on because you want it to last a little longer, because it is a cheaper one. But so I tend to put two to three layers on. That's just habit too. But they're very pigmented, so if you're on a tight budget, need something quick on the go just to hold you over until you get your better stuff, I definitely recommend this. It's only $1, very pigmented, you can't go wrong with it. Does it last for hours? Depends what you're doing. If you're drinking and eating all the time, then no. If you have it on for a few hours, then yes, you know, then that's fine. So I have like at least 5 of these. They're great to hold you over. The latest I've been using that I love, 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 and I bought 3. Now, I usually buy one first to see if I like it. These guys, I had to buy, like, 3 because I knew it was good because I've heard of the company. Oops, sorry. I've heard of the company flat out, and they were actually shown on TV on one of the morning shows, the Home and Family show that's on the Hallmark channel. I do end up watching that in the morning sometimes because I watch, you know, like I Love Lucy, Golden Girls, things like that in the morning, so that ends up being on there too. And they have some great DIY and home and family type of tips and tricks, you know, for you and the kids. They have a lot of great tips, so I do like that show, quote unquote. And they were talking about this year for Valentine's Day that just passed earlier this month, 2016, they talked about what are some products, lip products that are kiss-proof or considered kiss-proof that are good items. And wouldn't you know it, Milani, which I actually heard about before and I have eyed off and on, was on there. And I knew that they have great tips and stuff on that show. So I knew that if they were going to talk about this product had to be good. And I did eye them once or twice previously. So then I was like, you know what, I'm sold. I got to get it. Now this retails at about $20 as well as that other company. I got it on the actual Milani website. It was on sale for $9. I even checked eBay. I took it a step further because I'm always researching where I can get it cheaper. eBay, anyone selling this on eBay? $20, the original retail value. So even eBay couldn't beat Milani's sale price on their own website. Honestly, you can't go wrong. So I bought 3. I bought 3. And let me tell you, these are awesome. Definitely recommend Milani. They're not very expensive. I have a couple in here. One must be in my office. I got more the purple reddish colors. So I got Obsession, Fascination, and I forget what the other color is called, but I got more of like the reddish purple colors. These are gorgeous. They do last for hours. Very, very, very nice. Okay. And also when these dry, they don't feel very drying on your lips. So that's definitely a favorite of mine lately, is the Milani. I recommend it. Okay, now this is a love or hate brand, apparently. I've mentioned this in one of my previous videos. The Lime Crime Velveteens Collection. This is the official box. So it's the official product. Okay. I actually got this on Wish, on the Wish app. I do my research in advance to see what's real, what's fake, you know, what's out there cheaper. And they had the legit product, and it was a little cheaper by like half the price. I got it for $8, $9. Retail value on Lime Crime website is $16. And their lip stuff is anywhere between $60 and $20. Sorry, Michael Jackson, Thriller is on. I'll skip it for you. So he'll start singing now, just so you guys know. There you go. I don't mind a little MJ there. Alright, so, if you're all about the product, I would recommend this, actually. If you're about the background of the company, which is fine too, then I may not necessarily recommend this because they have a little bit of a history, not so nice history in past. But as far as I know, they changed their policies, so you're going to have to go research further on the background of this company and this owner of the company, because there's been a little controversy with the person. However, if you want to try the product, you don't want to pay the full price, and you don't want to support the company itself, go on Wish.com or eBay. Just make sure you do your research. Make sure it's the legit item, though, okay? Now, the color I got, and I love, let me tell you, I love cashmere. That's the color I got, cashmere. This is amazing, okay? You're probably going to see it in one of my other videos if you haven't already. It's amazing, let me tell you. It's great, easy applicator. It does not feel gross or anything when you put it on. When you eat, when you go out to eat with your friends or family, that actually stays put pretty damn well. The ones I've used that are good so far for going out to eat is that one, the Lime Crime. That's like my favorite so far. And the BH Cosmetics is pretty good. The actual Color Lock collection for going out to eat. Those are my favorite for going out to eat. Flat out. So that's my lip stuff. If you haven't seen already, I have quite a few. It's pretty much like this whole box is all dedicated to lip stuff, and I'm sure I'll have more. So that's my lip stuff. Next drawer. Now I can sympathize and be more empathetic as to why some of the makeup videos are so long when it comes to showing your vanity. Now I understand why. I don't have as much stuff in some of my drawers as maybe some of the other bloggers at the moment as far as their makeup stuff's concerned, because I'm still collecting stuff. But that's okay. So, let me see if I can show you here. My first drawer, my first right-hand drawer. I have this drawer dedicated to the liquid foundations that are CoverGirl, the Oil Control. I'm Classic Beige 530. I always get these on eBay or at Walmart because they're so cheap. And this gives me great coverage. It really does. So I definitely like these. So I have like 3 or 4 in here. BH Cosmetics makeup setting spray is really good. It's about $8-$9. But this has lasted me a long time since Halloween, okay, in my defense. Because I use it sometimes, I don't use it every day. I use it for like special occasions, okay? Honestly, my makeup lasts all day anyway with the stuff that I tend to purchase. So this is great for like if we're going to a wedding or some special event or Halloween. You know, you wear the cheap Halloween makeup, but you want it to last longer. This is something to use. That's why I got this. I got this specifically for my Halloween makeup. My Halloween makeup lasted all night. Really great. Drawer number one. Drawer number two. Drawer number two. I stocked up. Yes, I did. And I know I have a lot of space to add more, which I will, trust me. BH Cosmetics Liquid Foundation. Now, I'm all about my CoverGirl, okay? I really am. I'm not going to lie about it. But the BH Cosmetics, I've actually tried. I bought different shades, because I was trying to figure out what shade I am. I've seen and heard reviews about how this product line from them tends to run a little bit darker than what it looks like. So I got a couple different shades to figure out where I'm at. So I have some that are a little darker, a little lighter. I stocked up on these because they were on sale for like $3.50 not long ago. So I got like 6 or 7 of these. My lightest shade that they have. And then the next one up that was a little darker,
for contouring. They say to go between 1 to 3 shades darker when you're doing contour, and then this one's actually really dark. I haven't really found use for it yet because it was a little too dark, but I might play with it for contouring because you have to have a darker shade anyway. Since the top fell off, just to show you, it has like a little pump. You only need like 1 to 2 pumps. Surprisingly, it might not look that big of a container, but, or maybe it does, but honestly, this does last a while. This actually lasts me, man, I want to say it lasts me at least a couple of months, few months. This stuff lasts a while, but I stocked up because, on the product line, because it was so cheap. Retail value is $9, they sell it usually for $6, and they had it on sale for $3.50. I could not say no. If you're a makeup person like me, you cannot say no. Third drawer, it looks like a third and a fourth, the style of it. So it's a deeper drawer. This is where I have my hair products, my hair stuff, because I was able to fit hair stuff in here too, not just makeup. So I have everything from headbands, which you can get on eBay as well, really cheap. You know, like your little rubber band stuff. I have scarves in the back, and I've been using lately for colored hair the John Frieda Frizzy's Heat Defeat Protectant Spray. This is something you spray your hair right before using a hot tool on your hair, so it's like one of those UV protectant that keeps the color in your hair. So when you go out in the sun's gonna try and deplete your hair color actually. So if you use any type, whether it's a spray, like the spray conditioners when you get out of the shower or something like that, for using a hot tool, that's a UV protectant. It helps keep your color stay in longer. I have 2 sprays. This one for the hot tools, and I have one for when I get out of the shower, when I'm not going to do my hair that day. Just let it air dry and keep it, you know, natural looking, because I'm not going out, I'm staying at home. I'll just use the, I believe it's, I want to say it's the Philips, it's like the higher brand name, UV conditioner spray. I just spritz it, you know, just spritz it after I get out of the shower, good to go. But I use this one if I'm using hot tools. And I can actually fit in here, I can actually fit like my curler, my straightener, so I have a section specifically for hair stuff. So that's that for the right side. I already showed you the middle drawer, so I'm not going to bore you with that. So I believe I already showed you all of that. Under my computer, which I'll move this for you guys, get a little background view behind the scenes with Intuitive Mara. Okay, I'll try to keep this as straight as possible for you guys, so I apologize if it's a little shaky. First drawer on the left. I just organized all of this day before yesterday. Now, an extra tip, okay? If you have or you purchase one of those old school sewing boxes, and let's say it came with an extra layer, you know, like this acrylic layer for your box, but let's say that extra layer, it doesn't fit. Like this one, I actually got 2 with my kit. It did not fit. Both did not fit. It was one or the other. So what I did was I kept it. I cleaned it. I cleaned this first, and then I put it in here to see if it fit, and it fit perfectly. So I decided to use it as additional storage. So you can use pretty much anything you got around the house. So you can use these, okay? So I have my mascaras, which I'll have to buy more. I do have some extra liquid eyeliner is my thing. The Almé, Black is Black. I love these. I love Maybelline the most, as far as, and CoverGirl, because this one's CoverGirl. As far as mascaras go, I'm trying to find more companies out there that have these great products but that are animal cruelty free. I'm trying to find more and more because apparently some brands aren't, which kind of sucks. So I'm trying to look for more. I have extra pencil sharpeners, any little odd tools. This I got online. You can find online for like less than $4. This is a makeup brush cleaner. If you don't have the big expensive machine, you just put two fingers in there. I know that sounds bad. You put it like this under the faucet. Put some soap on here and then rub the brush with the other hand on here to clean the brush. I gotta clean my brushes here soon too. I've been kind of avoiding it. I got some deep wrinkle cream. It actually fit there, so I was like, awesome. This is something new I bought. My BH Studio Pro Brow Palette. It was about $12. I rather wait to buy this than buy the smaller ones that only give you 3 wells. This one gives you all of them. Honestly, it's more worth it and cheaper to get the big one instead of getting the little ones over and over and over. This is cheaper because 3 of the little ones is already $15. Why? When you can get this for 12, you know? So that's why I got that. Then under here, since these are usually those little pinwheel, the little, you know, the little sewing pinwheels, you know, for like your sewing machine, for the threads, they usually go in here. But remember, this is an extra layer, shelving layer that didn't fit in my sewing kit, so I'm reusing it, right? So what I did was I used it for brow pencils. You got brow pencils, whether they're in the box or not. These are still in the box. These are new. They actually fit. So, and they differentiate, you know, like you can put the different ones in here, wherever you want. So, if I wanted to pile more in here, I could. See, I can put it the long way too if I want the thick way. I could fit maybe 2 per row, perhaps. Unless they're like mini ones, you can probably fit more. Or you can fit lipsticks, whatever your preference is. You know, you can use that space. Don't think you can't. I got a ring sizer here. It was kind of out of place. I just put it in here, honestly, since I have other little tool stuff. You can still reuse the space here as long as whatever you're putting in here is, you know, not surpassing the height of your drawer. Like this, I wanted to put here, but obviously it's a little too tall. I can't do that. So I just put it up here with the rest of my brow stuff, and that's fine. So there you go. Second left drawer. Now this one's definitely filled. This is all of my eyeshadow. I try to keep my lip stuff and foundation on the right and the left side of my vanity, more the eye stuff. And then whatever odds and ends, but mainly eye stuff. New thing, which happens to be BH Cosmetics. I actually just got this recently. The glitter collection. I have platinum and gold. I do have videos showcasing the products, you know, using them, trying them. They are good. These are about $5 each, unless they have an extra sale. I got them for like $1 off. They look small, I'll be honest. They do look a little small, but honestly, they pack in so much glitter in there. This is something that's long lasting, just so you know. Little goes a long way with this product. Honestly, it's going to last a long time for me. I got platinum and gold, which is basically silver. Okay, I got to show this first because it's bigger. This is another Ferrero Rocher box. Clearly, you can see my family knows I love Ferrero Rochers. I grew up on them. There's a little bit of a family tradition with Ferrero Rochers during the holidays. And I guess I was a really good girl this past Christmas because I got a lot of Ferrero Rochers. Being a chocoholic, this lasts me like for a while. So this was one of the bigger, deeper sets that gives you like a couple layers of your chocolates, right? If you're a Ferrero Rocher like me person. This is a great, great acrylic box that you can reuse. A box like this at a store is $40. Online, maybe $20, $30. Obviously for me, free, because the Ferrero Rochers were a gift, so I repurposed the box, and it looks nice. And this, just so you know, this is straight up nothing but eyeshadow tons and tons of eyeshadow accumulated over the years. Clearly, I do not need eyeshadow for a really long time, unless I want to sample some new ones, which I'm sure I will do. And these were also gifts as well, so I actually didn't pay for this. These are about 100 or so, maybe a little more, eyeshadow wells. I actually have two.